Problem is to write a Python program to convert string to date time. Hello everyone, a very warm welcome to WS Cube Tech. My name is Ayushi Jain. In this video, we will learn how to write a program that will allow us to parse a string into a date time. Now, what is parsing a string into a date time? Now, suppose we have a string and inside it, we have written a date in a proper format and we want to convert the string type into a date time type. Then in that case, in Python, we have two methods that would allow us to get the output. Our first method would be the using the date time module, and our second method would be by using the date util module. So we'll be looking at both the modules one by one, talking about first of all the date time module. Let's have a look on how it works. First of all, we need to convert a string into a date time. So let's get a string over here. I'll be writing a string a is equals to, inside this I'll be passing some values. So first of all, let's say I want to pass this month, October. Date is 14 and I'm talking about the year 1997. The time over here is 7:15. That means 7:15 in the morning. So for the morning, I'll be writing AM. Okay, let's print its type. So if I write print type of A right now and run it, it would give me the output that it belongs to the classes of string. Now, what do I need to do? I need to convert it into a date time. To convert its type into a date time, I will be importing the module that from date time, import date time. Once we have imported date time, we will be using a variable called as date underscore time is equals to date time dot strip time. So strip time over here will allow us to parse a string that would represent a time in a correct format. Okay, so I'll be giving the format over here. So I need to represent my date, that is our A. So you can write A also, or let's make it as date as well. So we can write this one as date and we'll put this as date and this one as date as well. So we need to convert this date into a format. What format this is going to be? Let's write that. So in the double quotes, I'll be passing percentage B for the month. For the day, I'll be writing percentage, that is modulus D. Then we have year. For year, we write percentage, that is modulus capital Y. After this, we have hours. For hours, I'll be writing modulus capital I. I'll be putting the symbol of colon and then I'll be writing modulus capital M, which will represent the minutes, and then modulus for AM PM I'll be writing P. And as there is no gap in between over here, so I will also remove this gap from here. Let's print date time and also print its type. So print type of date underscore time. Let's run and see what output we'll get. So it would tell us that we have a classes of string. 1997 is the year, 10 is the month, date is 14, 07 is the hour, 15 is the minute, and 00 is the seconds over here. So, and it would give us the class, that the class over here is date time dot date time. So that means we have converted our string into a date time over here by using a simple module that is called as date time. Now talking about our solution number two, would be using the date util module. Let's have a look on how it can be done. So to use the date util module, we will be writing from date util import parser. Now parser is a function that allows us to convert, that means to that allow us to parse a string into a machine readable code. So I'll be writing a variable called as date underscore time is equals to parser dot parse, and here I'll be passing the values. So my values would be again the same. Inside the double quotations, I'll be writing October 14, 1997, and I'll be passing the time as well, that is 7:15, and I'll be writing AM. Once I'm done with this, I'll be printing date time. So inside this, you don't need to create a string before. You can just pass the string right after parser.parse and it will parse it into a date time. And if I print date time and print the type of date time as well. So let's have a look on what output we'll get. As you can see, I've already commented my previous code. So I'll be just running this one. Let's run and see what output we'll get. So as soon as we have run it, we have got the output that 1997 is the year, 10 is the month, 14 is the date, 07 is the hours, 15 are the minutes, and 00 are the seconds. And class is date time dot date time. So even previously, we were getting the same kind of output. That means our string was converted into what date time. And in this method also, we have got this same output that our string now has been converted into a date time. Only difference over here is that here you can create a variable beforehand. And after that, you can write a variable called as date time and write date time dot strip time. Strip time allows us to represent a string in the format of a time. And then we can write the format over here, that is our date. That date needs to be converted in this way, that in our date, our first thing is the month, second thing is the day, third thing is the year. Then after that, we have hours, colon, minutes, and seconds, and meridian. Similarly, our second solution says over here that from our date util module, we'll be importing parser and we'll create a variable called as date time. Inside this, we'll be passing our string, and that string will automatically get converted from string to a date time class. And the link of this code is present inside the description. I hope you guys have no doubts and no questions. And for more such interesting programs, stay connected, guys. Thank you.